Hello, hello, hello everyone. My name is Ross. If you have not seen one of my videos before, I am 19 years old. I live in Minnesota and I am gay. Today I just wanted to talk about a letter that my grandpa sent me and kind of reach out there for you guys and give you guys advice and have me as an outlet for you guys to talk to. So, earlier this week I got a letter from my grandpa and he sent me this letter with an article attached to it. The article that my grandpa sent me was a Dear Abby article, and I would like to share that with you guys. So I'm just going to read it off my computer. Dear Abby, you mentioned in a recent column that few people write to follow up on what happened since their original letter was published. You printed mine April 1st, 2001. I'm hurting in Houston. The son who with his partner was suddenly no longer welcome in his parents' home after they moved to a retirement community, because they were afraid their neighbors would shun them if they discovered they had a gay son. You advised that I should live my own life and maybe someday they would come around, and that is what I did. After a number of years, I received a call from a sibling informing me that my father was ill with only a short time left and I should fly to their city to see him. I asked if I was wanted and if and I should fly to see him. And he said, "It doesn't matter, just come." So I swallowed my pride, flew there, and made my way to the hospice house. Although my mother received me well, Dad did not, and we never had a good moment before he died a few days later. I told my mother I was staying for the funeral, whether she liked it or not, and I had my partner fly in. After the service, there was a gathering at my mother's house with all their friends. I introduced my partner to them, and everyone was kind as could be. Many mentioned their own gay siblings or relatives. When the event was over, my mother said, "Wow, this has all been pretty silly, hasn't it?" It was such a colossal understatement that I could not find words to respond. 10 years have passed. My mother is now in hospice care with only a short time left. We have built a great relationship, and she loves my partner of more than 20 years very much. We are glad to be able to be there for her. Much has changed in the world over years, and the acceptance of gays has been remarkable. But for me, having these last years with my mother's love will be a comfort that I can hold on to for the rest of my life. I have no great moral here. I just wanted to let you know what has happened. Thank you, Abby." And attached was a letter that my grandpa sent me, and it said this: "Dear Ross, the enclosed Dear Abby column was in Thursday's Pioneer Press. When I read it, I immediately thought of some of the situations you might get into as you go through your life. I'm certainly not suggesting that your mother or father would ever react to the way this man's parents did, but you'll live a long life and meet many people who will surprise you with some of their actions. I just want you to know that you will always be welcome in my home, wherever that home may be. I'll do my best to make it a place you'll be pleased to visit or stay in at any time." And he said, "Love, Grandpa." And I just thought that was a really awesome thing for my grandpa to send. When I first came out, I didn't tell him, and I actually never really did. He kind of just found out through my parents. And last year, he found out about my boyfriend. I had a talk with him about it, and he was very accepting, and it meant a lot to me. And the thing is, you guys may not know it, but your parents do love you. Your grandparents do love you. And when you come out, you could have a bad ending and you could have a good one. Either way, just the fact to get that feeling out of your system, get that weight lifted off of your shoulders, it helps so, so much, you guys. What my grandpa sent me meant the world to me. And if any of you guys have family that has accepted you, just be so, so, so thankful, because some people don't get the same privilege that you do, as some people have to deal with being kicked out of their houses or not being able to go see their parents, and it's not right, and no one should ever have to be in that situation ever. All right, that's pretty much it, you guys. I just wanted to end the video talking about something that I would like to do on this channel, which is like a Dear Abby segment, but it would be called Dear Ross. What I want you guys to do is to tell me your stories. I can keep it anonymous. I can keep it not anonymous if you want. Tell me your stories, anything you need advice on, all that kind of stuff. Send that to me on an inbox message on YouTube, and I will pick one, and I'll give you advice back and make a video about it. I thought that'd be kind of fun. If you guys like that idea, let me know down below. If you want to put your stories down below and you feel comfortable with that, go ahead. If you have something you need advice on, if it's like a short little thing, maybe I can compile a couple of those and put it into a video. So thank you so much. I know I'm only 19 years old and I haven't been through that much, but I've been through enough that I think I can give you guys some advice on some things. Some other things I might be a little clueless on. So I apologize if I can't answer your question, but I'll try to get to as many of them as I can. So thank you for watching, and peace. Don't forget to subscribe. All right, peace.